Now, dinner and drinks with a movie mobster. It was an offer that Craig Bennett couldn't refuse. In this exclusive interview with Goodfellas actor Paul Sorvino and his wife, Dee Dee Benke, we get the real inside story on the underbelly of Hollywood.
Tales of mafia, gangsters and violent mobsters are a Hollywood staple.
Say hello to my little friend!
The bold bravado of these colourful characters have been immortalised by the likes of Jimmy Cagney, Marlon Brando, Al Pacino and one fixture of over 100 mobster movies.
Holly, why would I want to get into that?
Don't make a jerk out of me. Just don't do it.
But like all acting greats, in real life, Paul Sorvino is nothing like the bad guys he plays on the silver screen.
I'm not the guy that people think I am, but I understand that I do fall in that category. I look like it, I can play it, and it's fine.
Goodfellas is such an iconic movie.
One of the best movies I think ever made, I really do.
That's
what I feel very
say.
Privileged to have been in it.
Well, you run a joint. Maybe I'll try to help you, all right?
God bless you, Paul. Okay. I appreciate it. God bless you. Always been fair to me.
All right. Some girls, they
like candy. In 1990, he was cast by Warren Beatty to star as Lips in the cult classic Dick Tracy.
Sign it.
The deed to the Club Ritz?
That's right. I'm going into show business now.
The movie, based on the comic strip Detective, was directed by Warren Beatty and starred Madonna.
Madonna, she didn't want any part of me. I don't know why. And so I just said, okay, that's it for you, you know.
Whose side are you on?
Side I'm always on. Mine.
I'm an Italian. Nothing works on me. You want to? By the way, we've become very good friends. But she was, that day, she, for whatever reason, maybe transferentially, she had a problem with me. And we do the scene, and I just completely ignored her. And after we've been working together for about a half an hour, she becomes very friendly. I can't explain it, but then we became really good friends. I think she's a very, very talented woman.
And she probably can't explain it either.
No, I don't know what happened.
He has starred as Henry Kissinger in Oliver Stone's Nixon, but there was one iconic role that got away. The Godfather, you could. Just could, maybe possibly, have been in that movie.
Yes, in point of fact, when I read the novel, I immediately said Brando for The Godfather, and I said me for Sonny, because I looked the way he was described, 6'3", oval face, big guy, strong shoulders. I looked like, you know, I was like an Olympic athlete.
Paul believes that because a female friend of director Francis Ford Coppola made saucy advances toward him, he missed out on that role of a lifetime in that legendary film.
Coppola's very cool. I had met him once before at a party. He was there with a girl who was paying all kinds of attention to me, with whom I had no interest.
You mean she was making a move on you?
Yes, and
Let's get this straight.
I was there with my wife who had the child the next day. So, I mean, I wasn't, first of all. That's history. We go to the thing, and we do read through. The guy on the left was a model type. The other guy was a terrific actor. He's helping to read people. Okay. You know, we do it twice. I said, Mr. Coppola, is there anything different you'd like me to do? He said, I think you'd be scared. No. All right, let's do it again. We did it again. I go to shake his hand. He walks away from me. I said, okay.
There was something happening here, clearly.
Clear. So I walk out, and this other really good actor walks out at me. I said, wow. I said, by the way, you are a great actor. He said, so are you. I said, couldn't tell from what happened in there. He said, I don't understand that. I said, was I any good? He said, you were sensational. I said, oh, well. Anyway, my name's Paul Sorvino. I said, my name's Bobby De Niro. So, and of course, he was so great from the get-go. Right away, I knew. You could tell instantly the magic and the reality and the depth. And then we found out later he had wrote next to my name because my agent knew his secretary. He said, I love him and I hate him. He's not a good-looking man, and I guess... Maybe he has to buy it. Who knows? I
really don't. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, Paul. He has also etched out an impressive career on the small screen, starring as police sergeant Phil Ceretta on Law & Order, but decided to walk away from that role after just one season.
Well, how many different ways can you do? What did you see when you came out of the coffee shop? I mean, is that what I was meant for? Is that what my thespianic gift is for? I thought it was for King Lear. I thought it was for Goodfellas. I thought it was for, for Oh God. I thought
Paul's
it was
a movie guy for sure.
I didn't think it was to just talk, and I couldn't stand it. But when I went in, it was 62 in the ratings. And once I'd been on 2 weeks, it was 22. So I had a following, and still do, and brought in all these extra people. At the end of a season and a couple of months, they said, well, we're all gonna take pay cuts. I said, bye-bye.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore.
Paul has been married to the vivacious and bubbly Dee Dee Benke for almost 4 years, an Emmy Award winner and former aide to President George W. Bush. And for Paul, it was love at first sight.
Well, we were doing a show like this, we're doing a TV show, and it was called Neil Cavuto, and he's an Italian, so we owe Neil, and he knows that. So Paul was having an interview with Matt Obama, and how he was disappointed, I think, that was the interview, and then I was on there frequently, so I took his chair, and then he started stalking me.
You're a stalker?
He was a stalker.
Wow.
A very good one.
You heard it here first, folks.
And the producer, he said, hey, and he said, do you want to go get a drink next door? And the producer's like, or Paul's like, oh, is she coming? And then the producer ran over begging and pleading, and you're like, you have to come do this. I'm like, what is wrong with you? And then I figured out it was Paul that put him up to it. So then we go next door, and Paul pulls a fast one and gets the ball rolling.
I saw an aura around her. Now, you can well imagine I'm not an aromatherapy kind of guy. You know, you can pretty much figure that I'm not into, if I can't pick it up and drink it, it doesn't exist, okay? So to me, it either is or it ain't, but I was so bowled over.
Paul and Dee Dee have combined their love of throwing parties and cooking for friends and created a cookbook aptly named Pinot Parties and Pasta. Up next, in the kitchen with Paul, as he teaches us a simple pasta recipe that anyone can cook.
Vita bella, vita bella, vita bella, hearts will
rise. Well, he starred in films like Goodfellas and Dick Tracy, but did you know that actor Paul Sorvino is also a king of the kitchen? In part two of our exclusive interview with Paul and his wife Dee Dee, Craigie Bennett discovered that this movie mobster is also a master chef.
He's the go-to man when Hollywood needs a movie mobster. But away from the screen, he's a gentle giant. Paul Sorvino is a triple threat, and yes, there is the acting. But he's also an artist. In his spare time, he loves to paint and is a sculptor. In fact, he's planning to make sculptures of the late Whitney Houston and Prince, immortalizing them for years to come. And another of Paul's passions is in the kitchen, where he and his wife Dee Dee love to cook for friends. Paul was kind enough to show us his marinara recipe, starting with lightly fried garlic and 2 tins of tomatoes.
Pureified.
You want texture in there.
Texture. Mm-hmm. So this is a good way to do it. It's easier when you use a stainless pan, you know, because it doesn't scratch the Teflon. And that's going to happen. You're going to make a mess if you're cooking well. Don't worry about it. First time I did some cooking when we were first married, she said, what have you done in my kitchen? Because when you cook well.
So he's a messy cook.
Oh, yes.
Is that right, Dee?
When he makes the gravy, it looks like a murder scene. I walked in, and that was our kitchen in New York, and it was a white stove, and there was, looked like blood everywhere. I was like, what have you done? And he said, hey, that's just the way it works. It's an Italian thing. And I said, all right.
This is ready. See this, how nice it is? Nice.
That looks terrific, Paul.
This now calls for...
Right off the basil plant.
Right off the fresh plant. If you can get a fresh plant or grow it yourself, it's easy. Get a plant, put in 3 or 4 of these.
So do you chop the basil or you tear it or you just
like
pop
that.
Those leaves
just
like, in whole?
Just like that.
Whole.
A little oregano, not much. People ruin this dish by putting in a teaspoon of this, you kill it.
I must say the aromas are absolutely beautiful. Those tomatoes, the garlic, the basil, and now just that little touch of oregano.
Exactly, salt and pepper.
We always like maybe putting a little wine.
Yeah, as an option.
As an option.
I see you're taking the option.
Yes.
Yeah. It's sometimes gives it a nice lift.
It's nice.
And
well,
I like
tomatoes
also.
Need a drink too, don't
yeah.
they? Feeling very left out here, actually. And a good grind
this
of black pepper.
That is about the whole story with marinara. And we'll turn it down because we just want it to simmer. So we want it to just do blip, blip, blip. Right now it's simmering quickly, and this goes all over the place. It does. Now you can make it in a larger thing, but this is traditionally how we make it in a big frying pan or skillet.
But it smells so beautiful,
doesn't it? Oh, it's fantastic. We added salt, we added pepper, We added basil, we added oregano, we put garlic, and that's it.
And
there
wine.
Is nothing else to put on.
And wine.
And a little
and wine.
Slurp
we touch
of wine.
A touch of wine to give it a little lift.
That's right, just
now,
a lift.
I am, need, no, I am needful of sitting down.
This is a simple recipe that any kitchen pro or novice can whip up. And let me tell you, it tasted like it was straight out of a mobster movie.
You may notice that there's no cheese at this table.
I do, actually. I was thinking, where's the Parmigiana?
Because in a garlic sauce, you don't add cheese.
Is that right?
That's correct. When I had my restaurant called Sorvino's Ristorante in New York, I make a dish called pasta fagioli, which means beans with macaroni. Now, that's not a soup like a Tuscan bean soup that so many restaurants make. And most everybody wants cheese on everything. My waiters were instructed you are not to bring cheese to the table for this dish. So people would say, I want cheese. He said, sir, the cheese is on the stand there. Feel free to go and get it. If I bring it to you, I will be fired on the spot.
Wow.
That was the stuff.
This is absolutely incredible. What do they say in Italy? Bellissimo.
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 Minus the cheese.
You don't put cheese on this or I'll come to your house.
I know.
You don't want me to do that.
I'm turning this back on him.
Is a horrifying prospect.
No party with Paul and Dee Dee is complete without a cocktail or 10.
This drink, I think, is the most popular drink in the book. It's called the Goodfella. Mm-hmm. And it is dangerously.
Wonder why.
But it's, she named them, she made them, it's all her thing.
Yeah, there are 10 signature cocktails in the book, and they're all great, and they're all very unique. But this one is special. I think it's award winning. It's going to win awards all over the world. So we have a shot of Jack Daniels, and then we're going to add scotch.
Scotch?
Yes.
On top of Jack Daniels?
Yes. Not a peaty scotch.
I thought she was crazy.
A smooth scotch. So, you know, like a McCallum.
I thought she was crazy too.
Yeah.
The next shot is cognac. The secret ingredient is limoncello. Limoncello fixes everything. And we add a little lemon wedge, because that's what Paul likes, and voila. Let's make a toast. To the book and to our new Aussie friends.
Oh, wow.
And thanks
what
for celebrating
fun.
The book with us.
Can I just say it's been an absolute joy to be in your kitchen.
Thanks.
So happy to have you.
And in your bar. Here we go.
Here we go.
I'm nervous.
I told you.
You were pickled by the end of that.
Constantly.
How were you still standing up?
I wasn't.
That is.
It was all an illusion.
What an amazing story.
And what an amazing man.
He actually invited his home. And
you bet.
Wow.
He was just wonderful, I have to say, Paul and Dee Dee. They are the most fun, fabulous people. And you may have noticed, for those with eagle eyes, he loves cooking pasta, and you may
lots
have seen his... yeah, well, I mean, you'd be mad not to. I think his mother said, keep your fluids up, dear, and he took her at a word. But on their stove, they have it's plumbed in. So rather than taking the big pasta dish to the sink and filling up, you just turn on the tap and it fills up right there over the hot plate. I mean, how is that for, you know, just... absolute indulgence, Hollywood style.
That's right. And what comes out of the tap is not water.
What a great story, Craig.
Oh, that was great fun.
Was it actually yummy?
Oh, that pasta was absolutely delicious. So
no
simple.
Cheese.
Yeah, I wanted the cheese. I'm with
you. When it's you make it at home,
it
or
yourself.
When you do Ding Dong Does Dinner, you can absolutely swamp it in cheese. Okay.